Hi, this is Gabriela Ortiz for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to introduce you to the new CIWith command in Stata 16. CIWith allows you to perform precision and sample size analysis for confidence intervals. When you are planning a study that uses confidence intervals for inference instead of hypothesis tests, you can use precision and sample size analysis to investigate the optimal allocation of study resources that ensures that the confidence interval will have the precision you need. With CIWith, we can answer questions such as, how many subjects do we need in a study to ensure that the confidence interval for a mean is no wider than 2? Or, if we only have enough resources to include 40 subjects in our study, what is the largest width of the confidence interval that we would expect? To perform this type of analysis, I would select statistics, and then power, precision, and sample size, and then I would select confidence interval. Note that I can perform precision and sample size analysis for the confidence interval for a one sample mean, variance, or standard deviation, and for a comparison of means from either two independent samples or from paired samples. When I select any of these methods, let's say CI for a two means difference, I'll see in the dialog box that I can either compute the necessary sample size, or the largest width of a confidence interval I can expect, or the probability that the width of the confidence interval will not exceed a specified value. This is analogous to power in power and sample size analysis. You can estimate these three elements regardless if you're working with statistics for one sample or two samples. The only difference is that with two samples, you can compute the total sample size or group sample sizes. So to compute the sample size required for a two means difference confidence interval, to have the width no larger than a target width, I have to specify the target confidence interval width and the desired probability of achieving the target confidence interval width. So for example, I'll specify a 96% probability and a width of 2 and a common standard deviation of 5. And here I get an estimated sample size of 434. Note that this was calculated by assuming equal group sizes, but I can also specify a different ratio for the sample sizes here, and I could also specify group-specific standard deviations here. I can also compare the level of precision that can be achieved given different sample sizes. So under Compute, I'll select CIWith, and all I have to do now is specify the range of sample sizes. So I'll specify 50 to 550 in increments of 100. And click Submit. And in the table, I see that as the sample size increases, the 95% confidence interval width that I can achieve with a 96% probability decreases from 6.69 to 1.76. I can graph these estimates by checking this box. And here I get a graph of those values. You can modify these analyses by specifying one-sided confidence intervals, allowing fractional sample sizes, or even adding your own methods to the CIWith command. And you can customize the graphs created by CIWith. If you would like to learn more about the new CIWith command in Stata 16, you can download the manual from our website at stata.com. Thank you for watching.